So hello everyone and welcome back once again to the session of government schemes. In this session guys, we are going to discuss another very important scheme of the Ministry of Education, and the name of the scheme is what? Shreyas. Okay, so let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon taki aapko videos ki notification time to time milti rahe. Let's begin with the session guys, and this is the scheme guys that we are going to discuss. What is the full form of Shreyas? So guys, as I told you, the full form is very very important to learn. Full form आपको याद रखना बहुत जरूरी है, उससे काफी सारी चीजें सॉल्व हो जाती हैं of a scheme. So what is the full form scheme for higher education youth in apprenticeship and skills, or in short we can say Shreyas. Okay, so if we go with the full form, we can easily identify the objective of the scheme. So there are 2-3 important words. One is higher education youth. So higher education youth कौन होते हैं? Those who are pursuing graduates or are already the graduate. Okay, so which means this scheme is for those who are pursuing graduates or for those who have completed their graduation. Okay, and these two words, skills and apprenticeship, denotes that there is some kind of industry apprenticeship opportunities that will be provided to the students who have completed their graduation or are pursuing their graduation. Okay, so what is the basic objective? The basic objective guys of this scheme is to provide industry apprenticeship opportunities to the students who are pursuing graduation or are already graduated. Okay, aur isse fayda kya hoga? It will enhance the employability of the students and it will also create the livelihood opportunities of the students. Okay, so I hope guys the objective is clear. Okay, and talking about the implementing ministry, so guys, it is very obvious that since we are talking about the students, then the implementing ministry should be the Ministry of Education. But here this implementation is supported by Ministry of Labor and Employment as well as the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Okay, but remember, the nodal ministry for implementation of this scheme is what? The Ministry of Education, while these two ministries are just supporting the implementation of the scheme. And what about the implementing agency? So it is Skill Sector Council. Remember this also, the implementing agency is what? The Skill Sector Council, while the nodal ministry for implementation is the Ministry of Education, and the implementation is supported by the Ministry of Labor and Employment and the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. Okay, and guys, talking about the components of the scheme, so I hope guys the objective is clear and the ministry is clear. So these are the two or three things that you do not have to read again. ये आपको दोबारा पढ़ने की जरूरत नहीं पड़नी चाहिए. And also the components. Components, guys, you also don't have to remember. This is just for the basic understanding of the scheme. What is going on in this scheme? Okay. There are only few things that you have to remember in this scheme that we will discuss later. Okay. So talking about the components. So number one component is what? Add-on apprenticeship. So this component is for those students who are pursuing their degree. Okay, जो अभी degree pursue कर रहे हैं. So the students are invited to choose a job or role of their choice from a selected list of apprenticeship programs, and the program would only be started after they complete their graduation. Matlab abhi wo pursue kar rahe hain, they can choose the, you know, the apprenticeship of their choice, and the program will be started once their degree is completed. Okay, and they will also get a stipend of ₹6,000 per month by the industry. Aur ye jo 6,000 per month hai, इसमें इंडस्ट्री का कंट्रीब्यूशन है, साथ ही साथ जो गवर्नमेंट का कंट्रीब्यूशन होगा वो भी है. एंड रिमेंबर वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग गाइस इन दिस स्कीम, दैट दिस स्कीम इज इंप्लीमेंटेड थ्रू द फंड्स ऑफ नेशनल अप्रेंटिसशिप प्रमोशन स्कीम. ओके, देयर इज वन स्कीम ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया व्हिच इज नोन एज नेशनल अप्रेंटिसशिप प्रमोशन स्कीम. सो अंडर दिस स्कीम द फंडिंग इज प्रोवाइडेड थ्रू द फंड्स ऑफ NAPS. ओके, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर. एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द सेकंड कंपोनेंट व्हिच इज एम्बेडेड अप्रेंटिसशिप, so guys, under this component, the existing bachelor of vocational programs, जो existing bachelor of vocational programs है, उनको restructure कर देंगे into the BA professional, BSc professional और BCom professional courses. Okay, and it would include not only the educational input or vocational input, but mandatory apprenticeship program of minimum 6 and maximum 10 months depending on the requirement of the skill. And here also a stipend is provided of ₹6,000. By the industry as well as by the government through the funding of NAPS. Okay, and talking about the third component, so linking national career services with college. So under this component, kya hoga? The national career service portal of the Ministry of Labor and Employment would be linked with the higher educational institutions. हायर एजुकेशनल इंस्टीट्यूशन के साथ इस पोर्टल को लिंक कर देंगे एंड इट विल बेनिफिट दो स्टूडेंट्स जिनके कॉलेज में कोई प्लेसमेंट सेल जैसी टाइप की चीज नहीं है. ओके, इट वुड हेल्प दो स्टूडेंट्स इन इंस्टीट्यूशंस व्हिच डू नॉट हैव द फैसिलिटी ऑफ कैंपस रिक्रूटमेंट. तो ऐसे इंस्टीट्यूशंस जहां पे कैंपस रिक्रूटमेंट नहीं होता वहां पे ये पोर्टल विल हेल्प द स्टूडेंट्स टू गेट देयर जॉब्स. ऑलराइट, सो दीज आर द थ्री कंपोनेंट्स. आई होप द कंपोनेंट्स आर क्लियर. If you can remember the name of the components, then that will be okay. Otherwise, if sab kuch yaad rakhne ki zarurat nahi hai, there is no need to learn everything. Just remember, there are three components. One is add-on apprenticeship, one is embedded apprenticeship, and another is linking National Career Service Portal with the colleges. Okay. And guys, now let's move on to the things that you have to remember. There are only 2-3 things that you have to remember. One, number one, it was launched in the year 2019. Launch year aapko yaad rakhna bahut zaruri hai. Then टारगेट, इट इज प्रपोज टू कवर 50 लाख स्टूडेंट्स बाय द ईयर 2022. 2022 तक 50 लाख स्टूडेंट्स को अप्रेंटिसशिप ट्रेनिंग दी जाएगी एंड दे विल बी प्रोवाइडेड स्किल्स थ्रू द अप्रेंटिसशिप ट्रेनिंग. एंड हाउ मेनी स्टूडेंट्स? 50 लाख बाय द ईयर 2022. एंड व्हाट अबाउट द फंडिंग, व्हाट अबाउट द फाइनेंसिंग? सो एज आई टोल्ड यू, द स्कीम इज फंडेड बाय द फंडेड थ्रू द फंड्स ऑफ NAPS, दैट इज नेशनल अप्रेंटिसशिप प्रमोशन स्कीम. So under this, central government shares 25% of the stipend per month, subjected to a maximum of ₹1500 per month. So वो जो 6000 रुपए का stipend था उसमें जो central government होगा, that will provide it maximum 1500 per month and during the period of the apprenticeship. And apart from that, an amount up to ₹7500 will be provided towards the basic training cost. जो basic training cost होगी उसके लिए ₹7500 will be provided by the central government. All right. So this is financing, this is target, and this is launch year. So these three things that you have to remember: target, which is 50 lakh students by the year 2022, launch year 2019, central government provides 25% of the stipend subject to a maximum of 1500, and basic training cost of maximum ₹7500. Okay. So guys, that was about the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear. Let me repeat this, summarize the scheme once again. What is the objective? To provide industry apprenticeship training to the graduates, to those students who are already graduated, or to them who are pursuing graduation. Okay, it was launched in 2019. 50 lakh students ko apprenticeship training deni hai by the year 2022. Financing iski ho rahi hai National Apprenticeship Promotion Scheme ke through, and there are three components. All right, and ministry of course is the Ministry of Education, supported by the Ministry of Labour and Employment and the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and implementing agencies. Skill Sector Council. Okay, so now let's move on to the questions, guys, that can be asked in your exam. Which of the following ministries have the responsibility of implementation of the scheme Shreyas? So, kaun si ministry milke isko implement karne ka kaam kar rahi hai? It's Ministry of Education, it's Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, and it's Ministry of Labour and Employment. Which means 2, 3, and 4. Option C, 2, 3, and 4 will be the correct answer. Question number 2 is, what is the target number of students to whom apprenticeship will be provided under Shreyas scheme? And this target we have to achieve till the year 2022. And the number of students is how much? Option A, 50 lakhs. 50 lakh students will be provided apprenticeship training under the scheme Shreyas. Alright. And question number 3 is, when was the Shreyas scheme launched? That's very simple question. It was launched in the year 2019. Option B will be the correct answer. So that's it for the scheme. I hope the scheme is clear and all the questions are also clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Milte hain kal ke session mein ek nayi government scheme ke saath. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.